Hello student, today I am going to let you know about acid, bases and salts. Acids, acids are those substances which are sour in taste and which turns blue litmus red. It neutralizes a base. Like hydrochloric acid, hydrochloric acid is chemical formula is HCl. Sulfuric acid is formula is H2SO4. Nitric acid, its formula is HNO3. Similarly, acetic acid formula is CH3COOH. Carbonic acid, H2CO3, etc. There are many acids, and acids have generally H plus ion in common, H plus aqueous ion in common. Aqueous means in water, solution in water is known as aqueous solution. If we dissolve salt in water, then we say that the solution is aqueous solution. The solution obtained by dissolving any salt in water is aqueous solution. Now, acids have generally H plus aqueous ion common. HCl, this breaks into H plus plus Cl minus. Aqueous H2SO4, this breaks into 2H plus plus SO4 2 minus. This is sulfate radical. HNO3 aqueous, this we have taken aqueous solution water, breaks into 2, this H plus plus HNO, H plus plus NO3 minus. These are the hydrogen ion aqueous in water in aqueous ion. H plus aqueous ion. All acids provide H plus ion in aqueous solution. And acid shows the properties, acid shows their properties in water only, that is in aqueous solution. Now, about bases. Bases are those substances which have OH minus ion. This is hydroxide ion. They provide OH minus ion in aqueous solution. NaOH, that is sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide. CaOH2, calcium hydroxide. This one is calcium hydroxide. Similarly, KOH, potassium hydroxide. These are bases, those substances which provide OH aqueous ion in water or in aqueous solution, they are said to be bases. Our bases are bitter in taste, and bases turns red litmus to blue. Like NaOH, sodium hydroxide, when we take solution of sodium hydroxide and we dip a red litmus paper, then it turns blue. Because this is turns red, it turns to blue. Similarly, CaOH2 calcium hydroxide also turns red, it was to blue. Potassium hydroxide, magnesium hydroxide, MgOH2, magnesium hydroxide, this one also a base. Bases have tendency to neutralize acids. Bases neutralize acids to form salt and water. Now about salts. Salts are formed by the neutralization reaction between acids and bases. Salts like NaCl, namely sodium chloride, similarly MgCl2, magnesium chloride, ZnO, zinc oxide, these are salts. Salts are formed by the neutralization reaction between an acid and base. But not only by neutralization reaction, salts are also formed by the reaction of acid with metal. When metal reacts with acids, then salts are also formed. At first, we take an example in which bases react with acid to form salt and water. Anyway, aqueous plus HCl aqueous. When these two mix together, then NaCl aqueous and water in liquid form is formed. Sodium hydroxide is a base. Hydrochloric acid is an acid. When these two react together, then sodium chloride is formed. And H2O is water in liquid state. We can take the other example also. NaOH plus H2SO4. When these two react, then we get Na2SO4 plus H2O. Sodium hydroxide reacts with sulfuric acid to form sodium sulfate and water. And this is the balance equation. To balance, we have to write 2 here. 2 NaOH plus H2SO4, Na2SO4 plus H2O. And hydrogen is 4 here at 2H2O. This is a complete reaction. And this one is also a neutralization reaction. Now, metal also reacts with an acid to form salt, like Zn solid plus HCl aqueous is ZnCl2 plus H2. Complete reaction is ZnH plus 2HCl. Balance equation. This one is balance equation. 2HCl. ZnCl2 plus H2. This one is a salt, aqueous solution, and this gas. Now, salt is formed by the action of an acid with a metal. Sometimes metallic oxide also reacts with an acid to form salt. Metal oxide also reacts with acid to form salt. Metallic oxides are generally basic in nature. Some of the metallic oxides are amphoteric, that is the oxide of the metal shows both type of characteristics, acidic as well as basic. ZnO and aluminum oxide, Al2O3. They are the amphoteric oxides. That is the oxide of marathon is so both type of characteristics. ZnO and aluminium oxide, zinc oxide and aluminium oxide. Amphoteric oxides. Amphoteric oxides. Those oxides, peptic oxides, will show both the properties, acidic as well as basic. Acid and base, both properties are shown by this oxide and they are amphoteric oxide. Now, about indicators. Indicators are the substances which change their color in acidic or basic medium. That is like a litmus paper in a litmus solution and litmus paper, two types of indicators, natural indicator are found, litmus solution and litmus paper. Litmus paper is found in two paper strips, red and blue, and this is violet. Now, like this litmus paper show different color in acidic and basic medium. In acidic medium, litmus paper shows red color. Litmus paper is red. In acidic medium, that is in acid, and it is blue. Litmus paper is blue in basic medium. That is ZnO extract also act as an indicator. It show pink color, light pink in acidic medium, and green color in acidic medium, and green color in basic medium. Green in basic medium. In basic medium. There are many types of indicators, but we have to learn about two types of indicators. One is a natural indicator, other is a synthetic indicator. Natural indicators are those indicators which are obtained from nature, either from plants or by animals. These are the other plants or animal products. Natural indicators and synthetic indicators. There are two types of indicators. Natural and synthetic indicators. Natural indicators, the examples are litmus paper or litmus solution, litmus paper or solution, and ZnO. Turmeric also acts as natural indicator. Vanilla onion, these are natural indicators obtained from nature, but these two are also called olfactory indicators are those indicators which change their smell in different acidic and basic medium. Olfactory indicators are vanilla and onion. They have the natural smell or odor in acidic medium, but in basic medium they changes their order or style. And since synthetic indicator, there are two types of indicator. Many use synthetic indicator. Those indicators which are prepared in laboratory are known as synthetic indicators. Like methyl orange, and phenolphthalein. Methyl orange and phenolphthalein are two main synthetic indicators which are used in laboratory, and these are also manufactured or produced in laboratory. And its color are different. Methyl orange is a yellow color in acidic medium. Yellow in acidic medium. Methyl orange and red. Yellow in basic medium and red in acidic medium. Red in acidic medium. And phenolphthalein. It is a colorless in acidic medium. Colorless in acidic medium. And it shows pink color in basic medium. These indicators change their color in different acid and basic medium. And in neutral medium, that is in neutral solution, it remains it retains its original color. Methyl orange is the orange in color. It remains orange in neutral solution. But it becomes yellow in basic medium and red in acidic medium. And phenolphthalein colorless in acidic medium and pink in basic medium. Now, there are two types of acids also. The first one is known as mineral acid, which are prepared in laboratory. Those acids which are prepared in laboratory are known as mineral acid, and that is obtained from minerals. Acids are of two types. There is two types. One is mineral acids, and the other is organic acid. Organic acid are obtained from nature, plants or animals, and mineral acids are prepared in laboratory. Like acetic acid, malic acid, these are organic acids, and in mineral acid, HCl, H2SO4, or HNO3, these are mineral acids, and organic acid, these are acetic acid, malic acid, these are obtained from different natural sources. That is apple, from apple we get malic acid, oxalic acid from spanish, oxalic acid, ascorbic acid, vitamin C, tartaric acid. There have been organic acids which are found either in plants or animals. Now about usage of acids. Hydrochloric acid is used in clean wash basins and other sanitary wares. It is also used in bathroom cleaner. And sulfuric acid is used in the automobile battery and in industry. Nitric acid is used by goldsmith. These are the uses of mineral acids. And tartaric acid is used to make baking powder. It is a mixture of baking soda and tartaric acid. Okay, now let's